Pete, first of all, your assessment of today's performance and the Tri-Series campaign as a whole?
Well, today obviously we're very disappointed because we were obviously well up for the game and we didn't really play as well as we could have done. I thought we bowled well up front this morning. We bowled well for quite long periods of the game and they got away at the end, so we probably chased 20, 30 more runs than we wanted to. And then batting wise, you know, we just didn't put any partnerships together, so you know, the batters will be very disappointed up there that they didn't perform.
Did you feel at Australia 60 for 4 that we had them in quite a good position? Is it a bit disappointing how they achieved 278 really when they were in that position?
Well, 60 for 4, we were in a great position. I think I give Marsh and Maxwell quite a lot of credit. I don't think we bowled badly at them. I thought they played really well. I think towards the end of the innings when Faulkner got away, we'll look back at that and we'll see areas we could have bowled better and plans that we could have got slightly differently. So we'll look at that. And Faulkner's dangerous at the end, back end of the innings. But, you know, we have to take that. I think some of our options we'd look back and we think, yes, we could have used different ones.
Just from a batting perspective, did you feel as though our performance could have been a bit better on that wicket?
Yeah, nothing wrong with the pitch. It was a good toss to win. So we got the best of the wicket. I think it played pretty well second innings. No gremlins in it at all. We just have to accept we didn't bat well enough. You know, our top score of 33 isn't good enough. We know that. We played well in the series, actually. You know, we've had a lot of partnerships, significant partnerships, over 100. We didn't do it today, and that's disappointing. So, I think the top order will all be... They were all very much up for the contest. I thought Australia bowled well, but not well enough to bowl us out for what they did.
But in the space of 3 weeks, there's been a lot of progression in the side, a lot of questions answered. Does that really please you? Because there's a number of areas which we seem to have fixed now and now down ahead of the World Cup.
Yeah, I think we're in a much stronger position. I really do. I think, you know, we've had a good 3 weeks. We worked really hard. We've had a couple of good wins against India. We got very close to Australia and Hobart when we batted very well. We look back today and we did some good stuff, but we didn't play well enough over the course of the game, so we have to take that. But yeah, we're in a better position. A lot of batters playing well, even though they didn't perform today. I thought bowling wise, Stephen Finn has had a good series. Stuart Broad, I think, really came back today, looked back to his best. Jimmy settled in very quick. And Moeen Ali obviously bowled very well today as well. So, you know, we've got some good positives to take from it, but we're not going to hide from the fact that today wasn't our day. I mean, I think we've got to take on the chin. I mean, it's a young team. I think one of the nice things with being an emerging team often is they're pretty open and honest about what areas they're going to look to adjust to get better. We've done that all the way through this series. I don't see any different today. We'll look at the areas we're going to get better, we'll go and do our work and we'll come back stronger. I think we are one of the sides that's getting better fast at the moment in world cricket, and we've got to keep doing that and keep progressing. Chris will be disappointed today. It just wasn't his day, and I think obviously the batting probably finished it off. It happens. The key is that, you know, he's had a really good winter, Chris. He's really moved forward a lot. He was probably the main standout bowler in Sri Lanka. And today hasn't been his day. He's got to take it on the chin. Look at areas, what options could I have taken? If there's something to learn from it, learn from it. Certainly not a lack of effort. And good fault and credit, he batted really well. Well, Gary's close. I mean, Gary's tapping again now. He's hitting in the net. So we'll get up to Sydney. He'll do a bit of work over the next couple of days because he's coming back from injury. And then when we get to Sydney, we'll see where he's at and whether he gets a go in the side. It's not over any one player. We've got Gary, we've got Alex Hales, we've got Treadwell, we've got Chris Jordan, all players who'd like to get a go. If we decide to give people a go in those games, we'll decide that later.